some believe, it's haunted. Is it? We're talking about the Athenaeum, and the building was recently featured on the show Ghost Hunters. Joining me is Craig Mintz, president of the Athenaeum Foundation, to talk a little bit more about it. You called Ghost Hunters.
Mm-hmm.
And the show came to Indy in July.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me how that went.
It was pretty amazing. And the fact that they responded, I thought, was the best part, right? It was a process that took about 6 weeks to get everything scheduled, but they came in over the course of a week, shot nights for that entire 6-day period. Sunday they rested and traveled, and I was there every night. It was insane.
Okay, they ghost hunt.
Oh, yeah.
That's what they do.
Correct.
You were there every night.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me what, first of all, goes into hunting, how they hunt for ghosts.
It's a lot of technical equipment, a lot of sound-driven results, and then a lot of visuals, obviously. So, you know, imagine a show much like this, lots of cameras, lots of audio equipment, but that is very mobile, moves around the building quite a bit, and in kind of zones and areas.
Okay, it's freaky. I mean, that building is 100 years old.
Oh, yeah.
The building's, I don't want to say it's creepy, but...
Yeah. I mean, it's old.
And
I mean,
it's
everything.
Dark,
yeah,
and it's night.
Yeah, right. And it was, you know, it hosted, you know, college classes and cadaver dissections back in the day. I mean, a lot of things have happened in this building. Nothing bad, but like just some interesting things, right?
Bodies.
Yeah, yeah.
That's not bad, but I mean, it's okay. So I know you can't give out a lot away because we're going to watch it here coming up. But is the Athenaeum haunted?
I can easily and 100% say yes. There's spirit activities in the building.
100%.
100%.
Were you, so when you get a group together and you're doing this, I mean, you know, you have fun with it, but sometimes you just let your mind go.
Yeah.
And it can really freak people out.
Oh, yeah.
Were you afraid?
Oh, yeah. Fairly regularly going into work. It's one of those spaces that you don't ever feel like unsafe, but you just feel something, right? Like almost like the building's kind of alive.
Yeah.
And it resonates. And especially at night, lights off, you know, your mind starts to wander.
Yeah.
You start to let it in, and it's just like, okay, this is kind of strange.
What is the strangest thing that you've ever felt or kind of seen or thought, like heard? Maybe like a door knock, someone knocking on the door.
So, I mean, the building's old, so it's got lots of creaks, so I kind of try to push that aside. But there are times walking through that building in the dead of summer where you just hit a cold spot and you're like, what is this? I've not seen anything personally, but I haven't been there very long.
Okay.
And I try to stay away from being there after hours by myself.
Let's go.
If I can help
Let's
it.
Go. Okay, so I got to wrap. The episode is Dancing with the Dead. Aired earlier this month, but Craig is hosting a watch party tomorrow night in case you missed it. The free event going to be at the Athenaeum at 7 o'clock. For more information and the ghost tours they do. They do ghost tours. Fox59.com/links. It's the perfect time of year to do a ghost tour. Set one up.
Oh, yeah.
All right, good to see you.
Good to see you.
Jim, we really need to go on.
Yeah, I'm all in on that.
We need to go.
That sounds like fun. Thanks so much, guys. We're at 8:44.